So the life cycle of Plasmodium begins with the bite. So remember that when we start this topic, NCERT base, it is going to be first life cycle, the portion of life cycle in the human being. So the infection stage of Plasmodium for human is the stage which is called as sporozoite. So Plasmodium is already present in the salivary gland of the female Anopheles mosquito, and the stage of that life cycle is sporozoites. So there are spores which are called here as sporozoites. So sporozoites is the infective stage. 2-3 years back this point came in the board exam, that infective stage in the case of the life cycle of Plasmodium is which one. So the answer should be sporozoites. So sporozoites are present in the salivary gland of the female Anopheles mosquito, and when she bites a person, she passes these sporozoites into the blood of the human being. So the parasite, with the help of the bite through the blood, reaches the liver. Hepatocytes here stands for the liver cells. So through blood, the parasites reach the liver, and then the parasite starts a sexual reproduction inside the liver cells. Please don't say it starts it in the liver, it starts inside the cells of the liver. So hepatocytes are the host cells in which the asexual reproduction occurs, and this asexual reproduction is called as schizogony. You need to learn these names for your MCQ type of questions for your NEET exams. So the parasite reproduces asexually in the liver cell, and then these liver cells will burst to release the progeny cells. So more Plasmodium parasites will come out and they are released into the blood. Now some of them will continue to attack more number of liver cells, and some will go into RBCs because they enter into blood. And inside the RBC, now what will happen? The parasite enters the RBCs and perform in the RBCs also the asexual reproduction. So it is called as schizogony. Now you can read one word here, erythrocytic, that means inside the RBC cells. So this can be called as ex-erythrocytic schizogony or pre-erythrocytic schizogony, because this happens before this one. And remember, some of them will continue to perform more infection in the liver. So that can be called as ex-erythrocytic schizogony. And this will be called as erythrocytic schizogony because it is occurring inside the RBCs. Now what will happen? The RBCs are going to burst. As they burst, they release a chemical which is a toxic chemical called as hemozoin, and this causes the fever in the human body. So the bursting of the liver cell, and which starts the cycle of the fever and symptoms. So why there is a sudden fever? Because so many RBCs, maybe thousands of them, they all burst simultaneously, and as they burst, they release a chemical called as hemozoin. This causes the start of the cycle of fever and the other symptoms. So basically, bursting of the RBC is responsible for all this, and released parasites will infect more RBC cells. Now remember that in some of the RBC cells, these asexual structures will change into sexual structures. Some of them will develop into gametocytes. Now gametocytes will be of two types, male gametocytes and female gametocytes. Now as they turn into male and female gametocytes, they will travel themselves intentionally into the superficial vessels. That means you all would be knowing that mosquitoes always bite in veins. That means they are biting in which blood vessel? Veins. And we all know veins are superficial, and veins are rich in carbon dioxide rich blood. So mosquitoes are able to easily pick up the presence of carbon dioxide. So that's why they always bite the veins, and that's why these gametocytes will go into veins. And as a new mosquito comes to suck or to take the blood meal from an infected person, then definitely these male and female gametophytes along with the blood will enter inside the body of another female Anopheles mosquito, and from here starts the life cycle of Plasmodium in the female Anopheles mosquito. So now what happened? Female mosquito takes up the gametocytes with the blood meal, and then when they reach the stomach, these male and female gametocytes undergo fertilization. As they undergo fertilization, this process can be called as gamogamy. गैमोगोनी, सो गैमोगोनी, शीजोगोनी, जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस वर्ड, शीजोगोनी फॉर असेक्सुअल, गैमोगोनी फॉर फर्टिलाइजेशन और सेक्सुअल, एंड दिस जाइगोट नाउ इलोंगेट्स एंड बिकम मोटाइल एंड इज नाउ कॉल्ड एज ओकाइनिड, एंड फाइनली इट विल मूव एंड देन मेक्स अ होल इन टू द वॉल ऑफ द स्टमक एंड देन चेंजेस इन टू, इट विल स्टिक टू द स्टमक वॉल एंड चेंज फ्रॉम ओकाइनिड, ओकाइनिड मीन्स मोटाइल फॉर्म, इन टू ओसिस्ट, सिस्ट मीन्स अ थिक वॉल अराउंड इट. नाउ इट विल बी अटैच्ड देयर एंड अंडरगो थर्ड स्टेप ऑफ द लाइफ साइकिल एंड दैट इज द स्पोरोगोनी. सो स्पोर फॉर्मेशन अकर्स इन साइड द फीमेल बॉडी and that is called as sporogony. So three words are there: schizogony in human, gamogony in female mosquito, sporogony also in female mosquito. So inside the oocyst, these sporozoites are formed with the help of sporogony, and then they are going to release into the gut of the female mosquito, and from there these sporozoites will again go back into the salivary gland and wait for this mosquito to bite somebody, and this cycle of infection is going to start again. Please remember that there are two hosts involved here, so it's a digenetic type of life cycle.